my name is Chin Kai, and I'm a member of the US Parliament representing Preston. Tonight here in Yorkland, 53 degrees, we had a wonderful night, and this is our third successful year holding the STAR event. We pass on the message to stand together against racism.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, boys and girls, my name is Russell Holbart. I'm an honorary fellow and community ambassador here at the university. It's an honor and a pleasure to be here this evening to welcome you to the university and this 53 degree venue. And thank you for helping us to support the Stand Together Against Racism initiative.
Today, out of love, we need to continue the fight for equality, freedom and peace. Still, enough has not been done. People are still attacked for their race. People are still bullied because of their sexuality. People are still discriminated against because of their gender. People are still killed because of their beliefs. Yes, hate crimes have declined over the years, but more can be done. Think more, love more. Who is your hero? Why are they your hero? What makes them a hero? These are just some of the questions I ask my Year 7 class when I'm teaching. The answers are sometimes silly, sometimes funny, sometimes inappropriate, beyond Year 7s. But they're all insightful. And there are a couple of names do come up. Nelson Mandela, Mahatma Gandhi, Mother Teresa, Rosa Parks. These people are the shining light of society. People who we aim to emulate, who we aim to be. And I ask the question, did they aim to be the star, the leaders? I don't think so. I think what they were trying to do was make a difference to the community, to the local people, for one person. I think that's what makes them heroes. Mahatma Gandhi says, whatever you do will be insignificant, but what is important is that you do it.
This. A day where 130 people will fall victim to a hate crime in the UK. A day where somewhere in the country a young person will be bullied or harassed on the grounds of their ethnicity or religion. A day where whole communities still live in fear. A day when a place of worship can still be a target. A day where we still believe the lies and propaganda spread by the media and by the far right. Now, whether we want to hear it or not, today will be a day of division, of hate, and of discrimination. No, we don't want a day like this. So instead, we're going to look to a new day. We can't change the past, but we can learn from it. We can't merely look back. We have to have hope and vision for the future instead. Now it's exactly this that the Youth Parliament voted for in November in the House of Commons. This year, the UK Youth Parliament will be campaigning to tackle racism and discrimination with the campaign Don't Hate Educate. The idea is simple, but it's one that's at the heart of the fight against racism. Ignorance is at the core of racism, and it's ignorance that makes us vulnerable to manipulation. And it's manipulation by those with hate in their hearts. Stemming from some sick jealousy or prejudice, it's their manipulation that plants the seeds of resent in people. Now, if we can be educated, enlightened, to the contribution that our diverse mix of ethnicities, and religions, nationalities and cultures in the UK makes to our everyday lives, maybe one day we can find respect and acceptance. We can be stronger together, strong in our diversity, strong not as individual races but as one human race. Yes, I believe there will be one day like this.
Successful. 2014 was the first event that this was held in County Hall. There was approximately 65 people in this event. We held it the second year again, and this time it was more successful with over 150 people attending the event. And this year it was our third year, so over 135 people doing it. In total, approximately 350 young people have sung their message on intolerance and racism in their community in Preston.
The Race Relations Act, but racism still remains endemic in British society. The growing hostility towards immigrants and widespread Islamophobia, anti-Semitism and many more are setting relations back to 20 years. In fact, it has risen so high that racial hate crimes are having to be recorded separately for the first time in the UK. This is clear evidence that we cannot be complacent about racial prejudice. Where it manifests itself, it damages our society. So it is up to us now to take responsibility to reduce racial prejudice and instead to promote racial harmony, to make a change in our community for the better. Remember that this will not be easy, but if we stick together slowly and gradually, we will make it to the top of the mountain and make a real difference for a better Preston, a better UK, and a better world. It's a climb.
No hell below us, above us, only sky.
Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there is no country. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. No religion to live. Imagine all the people living life in peace. The audience must be very familiar with these lyrics from John Lennon's famous song, Imagine. Well, do not scare you away. I apologize I wouldn't have sung this masterpiece tonight, but I think it's important for me to pass on Lennon's message. I admire him not only because of his talent in music, but also he's a warrior fighting on the front line against discrimination, racism, and inequality. He uses music, the universal language, to send his message to the world. This song is really asking the listener to give up on discrimination based on ethnicity, social class, religion, and nationalities. It was written during the high tide of Vietnam War. It was written to call for tolerance, to call for understanding, to call for peace. Today, I think this message is more important than ever. In the internet world, cyberbullying around race and culture keep appearing on our smartphone and social networks. In the globalized world, terrorism and the so-called Islamophobia attempt to disconnect people and replace love and tolerance with hatred and prejudice. Even in young people's everyday life, racist jokes are eroding the British values of multiculturalism from our younger generation. It is a time for us to project a powerful voice to the world, just like John Lennon did. I am so proud in our city, Preston, for its tolerance, diversity, and kindness. My friends, the world is listening, and we must not lose our voice. You may say I am a dreamer, but I am not the only one. I hope someday you may join us, and the world will be as one.
Standing Together Against Racism, another successful event again this year with 130 young people in the choir, almost 300 people in the audience. huge thank you to the four schools who took part: Ashton Community Science College, Our Ladies Catholic High School, Broughton High School and Fulwood Academy, and of course Preston Youth Council for again their fantastic speeches. And thank you very much to UCLan for all their support for providing the venue, and Creativity Works Preston for their tech, another great event. Thank you very much.
My name is Russell Hogarth. I'm an honorary fellow here at the University of Central Lancashire and a community ambassador. I was asked if I would help to host this event some months ago by the Pro Vice Chancellor, Lynn Livesey. And I didn't realise or anticipate what a fabulous night it was going to be. Not only the support from the LCC staff and all the other members, but the children were incredible. They were like angels on stage. And the power of the individual speeches was absolutely gripping. The audience were blown away by it, I certainly was, and we're hoping to do it all again next year.